Welcome back. So here's a question for you. How far is too far when it comes to television? What about two fully clothed men sitting on a couch discussing the silent, naked woman who stands before them? Cue controversy all across Europe, and more so because the programme was commissioned by Denmark's public broadcaster. According to the show's creators, rumours of misogyny have been greatly exaggerated by the international media. We sent Amos Roberts to see if there really was something sexist afoot in the state of Denmark. And a warning, as you would expect, his story contains full frontal nudity.
Gentlemen of Denmark, Thomas Blackman would like your attention.
Er de også det mest liderlige menneske, de nogensinde selv har mødt? Bliver de også tit rørt over dem selv? Rører de også tit ved dem selv?
Over six consecutive Tuesday evenings in April and May, Blackman addressed his countrymen about a personal crisis.
Ser de, jeg døjer med alt for meget porno på den ene side, og alt for meget politisk korrekt puritanisme på den anden. Men hvad med poesien? Hvor blev den af?
Until now, Danes knew Thomas Blackman as an award-winning jazz musician. And as the X Factor judge that audiences either loved or hated. But in his new show, Blackman wants to talk about women.
Kvindekroppen tørster efter ord, en mands ord. Det er derfor, jeg henvender mig til dem her nu. I den noble ambition om at repositivere kvindens syn på mandens syn på kvinden.
The format of the Blackman show is simple. Each week he invites a well-known Danish man, a fashion designer, writer, comedian, singer, to a very unusual encounter. Two men watch a naked woman. They start by discussing her body.
Min hånd ville kunne håndtere sådan et bryst.
Jeg har aldrig kunne finde ud af det. Jeg ved ikke, hvad jeg skal gøre.
Kan du vende foden til højre, eller drej den ned? Ja, sådan der.
Det er jo altså en smuk ankel og en flot svang.
Man lægger røv, det der. Det er der altså.
Det kommer ind
på. Prøv lige at se på den facade. Dejligt at se et naturligt bryst her. Det er fandme altså, der var, jeg ved ikke om det er en mellemgeneration eller hvad det er, som lige pludselig skulle pumpes alle vejene.
The woman's body becomes a catalyst for a discussion about the modern Danish man that sometimes borders on the bizarre.
Men jeg tænker også, det der må sgu da kunne noget. Altså kvinder i dag, hvor finder de sådan nogle mænd hen? De må da finde sig voldsomt understimuleret, fordi hvor fanden er han hen? Vi kommer imod det der pikløse samfund, som de selv har været med til at afmontere. Ja. Og så står der en mand ude i kulissen og siger, undskyld, jeg har fået en reaktion her, hvad skal jeg stille op med den? Altså, og
bare ned på knæ, frøken, og så finder vi ud af det. Hvad hedder det?
The loneliness, we have so much loneliness in this country. I mean, it's ridiculous.
Blackman describes his show as a mix of avant-garde art and social experiment.
To put two men into the most unthinkable situation, what's going to happen? And to put it on screen in people's homes, you know. And this idea, I just thought, wow, this is crazy. Let's do it and see what happens. Because it's needed to provoke. Man is very complex. And the masculine view on women, it's not allowed anymore. It's too dangerous. I mean, but we all have it. We all enjoy watching women. And we're not afraid of talking of women when we're by ourselves, but as soon as just one woman appears, we just stiffen up.
Did you need a naked woman to have this conversation?
Obviously, because, I mean, how many times have you seen just two men, the man and woman, talking on the television? But you put in a naked woman, I mean, it's just going to change the whole environment. It's just like, whew.
The female commissioning editor at DR2, Denmark's niche public broadcaster, agreed.
How did you react when Thomas Blackman pitched this show to you?
I got it on an email, and the first time I read the email, I thought, this is not possible, you cannot do this. And then I started thinking, well, why not? Why couldn't we do this?
Mm. The format was guaranteed to provoke, even before it was broadcast.
I saw first the trailers, which were shown very often in Danish television. They were very proud of this program. I think, are we really so low in 2013? I actually couldn't believe in it. So I was actually embarrassed because it's a public service channel.
Journalist and blogger Lottie Hansen wrote a formal complaint to DR2 before the show even went to air.
Kære chefredaktion, jeg forstår ikke, det er blevet til et program, og jeg hører ikke til dem, der ønsker at give det en chance. Jeg har set trailer og læst om konceptet, det er nok. For mig at se, er det journalistik, når det er dårligst, provokation for provokationens skyld.
I was surprised because the reaction came before the program had been broadcast. So it was really an automatic reaction.
Tonight, the final episode of Blackman is screening in homes across Denmark.
Øver de dem stadig i at virke munter?
Nej, ikke helt.
Jeg synes, han er så fræk.
Nej, jeg synes, han er latterlig.
Det synes jeg også, men der er alligevel ikke latter ved det.
Jamen, det der, det er jo selv i scenen til. Ja, helt.
These women are interested in analyzing Blackman, as well as his female guests.
Ja. Det er rigtigt, han har også den der meget feminine side. Ja. Ja. Og det er også en voksen kvinde, han har fået der. Mm.
Meget pæn bryst.
Nina Fenning has a special interest in this program. She herself has already bared all for Blackman.
Somebody told me that they were searching for women to a new program, Danish television, about naked women. Naked women in all ages, from 18 to 100, if possible.
Nina, a primary school teacher, only found out she was going to be ogled by Thomas Blackman the night before filming.
How did you feel when you found out?
Mr. Blackman?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yes.
Meget, meget smuk naturlig skønhed her, det må man sige.
Det er så sjovt.
Slanke de benene der, muskulaturen. Jeg får ikke præstation.
How did your family react to you being on this show?
My mom, she was the first one calling me. Oh, it's you! You're naked! I say, yes, mom, it's me. I say, oh, I just need to tell you, I'm so proud of you. You were standing there on my television, you are so beautiful. I'm so proud of you.
Jeg har en tese om, at kvindekroppen tørste efter en mands ord.
Do you think this is true?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, the right words.
Hvad antænder dig ved umiddelbart ved en kvindekrop? Altså, er der et sted, du hviler dine øjne, eller?
Ja, det er næsten altid brystet.
Selvfølgelig. Det var en stor overraskelse.
Ja, en big surprise.
What do you think of this guy?
He's a real man.
Yeah, he's a real man.
He knows a lot about women, I can tell you.
Yeah.
Blackman's guest tonight is psychologist and sexologist Sten Hegler.
Do you think that he's right when he says that a woman's body thirsts for a man's words?
Yes, and so what?
Now 90 years old, in the 1960s and 70s, Hegler pioneered Denmark's sexual revolution.
Can you see why some women were offended by a program in which two men discuss a naked woman who cannot speak back?
I once was in television and there was a fanatic feminist who spoke about how terrible it was to be a sex object. Then I said, there is something worse than that. And she said, what's that? I said, not being a sex object.
Plenty of people were offended by Blackman, men as well as women.
När blev det okej i ett modernt samhälle att använda människor som rekvisita?
On this Swedish TV show, guests accused the program of setting back the cause of women's rights.
som han säger i början, att kvinnokroppen törstar efter mannens ord. Jag törstar efter samtalet och männens tillit till min intelligens utöver min sexiga kropp.
Can you see why some women would be offended by a program which seems like a throwback to the old days where women were there to decorate rather than to have meaningful roles?
Yeah, no, I really can't. If they watch the program, they will find out that the intention with the program is exactly the opposite. This program is a tribute to women. So, no, I really can't see that.
Hej med dig. Perfekt.
I think it's important that we give another picture of what women really looks like. Today in society, female bodies are portrayed in the media as perfect. And this program, we show what really beautiful women looks like.
Why can't they talk?
Well, that was a decision from the production company, and you know, I could have changed it if I wanted, but I actually thought, no, it's fine. And they do talk as well, if you notice. They don't talk in words, but they talk with their bodies, with their eyes, with their laughter.
I mean, come on, women talk all the time. What a wonderful idea to just please, just be quiet for a second. And let the men talk.
Right. Ja, det gør, ja, det er fint. Det er dejligt. Jeg må sige, du har en flot krop. Du har nogle, er din egen bryster, det må du ikke sige. Du må slet ikke svare.
Jamen, det kender vi svaret på, kan vi?
We never know who these women are. We never know their names. They are just things to be looked at.
Yes. Yes, and they're there to be looked at. Yes, they are the sculpture in the studio. It would be a problem if we were living in a society where we had huge problems between men and women, but we don't.
They shouldn't have done it this way, because the fact is, and that's just so easy to see, that they treat the woman as a horse at a county fair, and they discuss how she looked like, and then they say, oh, an old horse could also be a good horse.
Altså, det var ben, der også bevægede sig under 2. verdenskrig, og fantastisk knæ også, ikke? Helt vildt med det lede liv, der ligger i den hånd der, ikke sådan en hånd der. Må jeg prøve at se din hånd?
And then they look at the old horse and say, oh, look at here, she have some hands, they're really old, but they have maybe done a lot of work, and that's what they discuss. And they should stop this phony intellectualization about this, because that's not true. They should just call it what it is. It's a county fair.
Og så skal I to bare fortælle mig, hvad I tænker, når I kigger på Andy lige nu her.
This was a good-humoured attempt at a reverse Blackman by a morning television show. Here a naked man is appraised by a female journalist and sexologist.
Har jeg lavet et nyt ord i dag? At en slapper, det ikke er særlig smuk, men altså, du er da flot.
Wow, siger jeg bare.
Det er dejlig morgen, det her. Jeg tror,
mænd vil gerne... Danes pride themselves on being relaxed about sex and nudity, and opposed to censorship of any kind. These 18 and 19-year-olds are being photographed for the new edition of a Danish feminist classic, Woman, Know Your Body. They were quite open to the idea behind the Blackman show.
Yeah, I just thought that it might show how different women bodies can be.
Did it bother you at all that the program was about two men looking at a woman's body?
Actually, I think I found it interesting to hear what men could say about a woman's body, but I think that the program is more about black men talking.
What is it about Denmark that means that a program like this exists?
the fact that we don't get offended anymore, perhaps.
The young feminists editing Woman, Know Your Body didn't even bother to protest the Blackman program.
As a woman, you can't say anything about it unless you laugh.
Laugh
about it or show some kind of appreciation of the show, that if you criticize it and say, this is bullshit, then you're just the angry feminist,
uptight.
Prudish,
yeah.
Uptight,
humorless,
yes.
man-hating, all this stuff.
It's called Blackman, a new Danish primetime TV show, and it has a very controversial premise. A woman enters a room.
Some feminists might have been unwilling to make a fuss, but when the international media found out about Blackman, they went berserk.
It's kind of insane. Like, my first reaction was almost, how did this ever get greenlit? Like, how does this exist?
Perhaps because Thomas Blackman was an X Factor judge, journalists assumed he was judging the women's bodies.
Okay, this guy's an asshole. Okay, no, the female body doesn't thirst for anything from Mr. Blackman.
Yeah.
It didn't help that journalists were too lazy to translate what was actually being said on the program.
What kinds of things do they say? I'm not actually sure, because the clip is not in English. Yeah, it's probably not. Yeah, probably not very nice things.
Thomas Blackman is hosting a party for the people who made his show possible. They're thrilled it's become one of the most downloaded programs on Danish public television, but they're furious at the way it's been portrayed overseas.
Fuldstændig vanvittigt, at man kan skabe 800 internationale artikler på baggrund af noget, som ingen
løgn,
har set.
Er løgn.
Er løgn.
Ja. Det er løgn.
Ja.
Der er ingen, der har set det.
Thomas Blackman is happy to admit he's arrogant and provocative. But he wants the world to know he's also sincere, and he's not a sexist.
Men has a craziness that women don't have. And we need that craziness, but that requires a liberated man who just don't give a shit about what other people think of him. His only interest in one thing is that to give some people something to think about, to express himself uncensored, and that doesn't make him a sexist.
Well, that's the end of my work day, and my body is thirsting for something, but I can assure you, it is not the words of a man. The very provocative Thomas Blackman there with Armus Roberts.